Thank you. Hello, everyone. Indeed, I will tell you today about TensorTraffic project aiming to predict traffic, or to be more precise, to approximate outcomes of traffic simulations, modeling, or also predicting traffic. But first, I will tell you that I'm very happy that I see you, because it means that you arrived safely to PyData and our presentation. And not everyone is so lucky, right? So right now, thousands of drivers in Warsaw stay in traffic jams, losing, wasting time, money. And it is estimated that drivers in seven largest Polish cities lose yearly almost 4 billion Polish zlotys because of traffic jams. Also, more than 1 million people each year die in car accidents, and about 20 million are wounded. So, it is a real issue which we should tackle somehow. So, how we can investigate traffic, right? So, if you think about possible options to do traffic research, we can divide these different types of traffic research into four basic parts. Modeling traffic, yes, if you want to investigate some real phenomenon, then we should have some mathematical models describing this phenomenon. Then traffic analysis, so if we can get some real traffic data or data from models, then we can analyze it. We can try to make some predictions. And finally, optimization, right, in order to improve some traffic parameters. So today, I will tell just a bit about modeling, much more about predictions, and at the end about applications of predictions to traffic optimization. So let's start. Traffic prediction is a quite well-known topic. Yes, so the research on traffic prediction started more than 50 years ago. So we can try to predict traffic in a short term, so try to predict what may happen in 10 or 15 minutes ahead, or we can try to do long-term traffic prediction, so predict what may be the state of traffic next day or next week at the same time of day, for example. And we can try to predict traffic congestion, so traffic flow, number of cars driving through a given road segment. We can also try to predict travel times. So travel times is something which is predicted, for example, by Google in Google Maps service. When we want to find optimal route, then each time Google not only analyzes current traffic data and historical traffic data, but also try to forecast short-term travel times. So usually good tools to make such traffic predictions are recurrent neural networks, LSTMs. There are a lot of research papers on this topic, and it is indeed a very interesting topic. And I'm also collaborating with one of company collecting traffic data on this topic, on traffic prediction. But today I'll tell you more about something which, in my opinion, is even more interesting, which is traffic prediction in atypical conditions. So, for example, if we have bad weather or there are roadworks, there are car accidents, then it's almost certain that state of traffic will be much different than typical traffic, right? So it may not be the same as typical patterns which we can find in traffic data. And this is much more difficult case. And some basic data analysis sometimes may not be sufficient to deal with it. Another useful tool might be, for example, traffic simulation, right? Because if you have traffic simulation and we can describe the whole road network in a city such as Warsaw, then we can just introduce proper changes to this road network structure and run simulations, try to simulate how the traffic may look like in this specific case. So I call it prediction what if, because we want to predict what be the state of traffic if nothing change, and if the traffic is typical, because we can relatively easily do it nowadays. But we try to predict what may happen if we change something in the road network. For example, what may happen if we change traffic signal settings. And if you think about it, it is a step toward traffic optimization, right? Because if we are able to predict what might be the state of traffic if we change something in traffic management system. For example, if we change traffic signal settings, then we can try to search through a large space of possible traffic signal settings in order to find optimal or suboptimal settings, right? So this is a step toward traffic optimization. So not only modeling traffic, not only predicting traffic, but also trying to deal and solve important traffic issues. As I said, the most popular and important tools to analyze traffic nowadays are traffic simulations, but accurate traffic simulations are usually time-consuming, especially in a large scale. So there are different approaches to do traffic simulations. There are macroscopic models which try to describe traffic in terms of aggregated values such as density, flow, and speed of cars, but there are also much more precise microscopic models in which each vehicle, each agent participating in traffic is described and represented as a separate object. So in some cases, we have to run a large number of such simulations with different settings. So for example, we may want to find optimal traffic signal setting. So if you want to evaluate in traffic simulation each traffic signal setting, then indeed it may be time consuming, right? And there are other similar problems, so usually related to some kind of optimization. For example, what should be optimal location and configuration of parking places or charging stations for electric vehicles? So we would like to do it as efficiently as possible, so we can try to distribute computations on graphical processing units or on clusters of many machines, but it may be still expensive and it has some limitations. So especially if you want to run many thousands of even millions of simulations or evaluations of different settings, then it may not be still efficient enough. But in many cases, we are not interested in the simulation process, but only in outcomes of these simulations, right? We are not interested what exactly is happening during each simulation step, but what is important for us is the result of simulation. So maybe we can somehow approximate outcomes of traffic simulations based on partial output data. So we may think about this problem as having some input to the simulation, which may be, for example, traffic signal setting. The simulation just computes a function, which values of a function, which might be, for example, the total delay of all cars or total time of waiting on a red signal. So this is just a real number, right? So this is a function. It may be also a random variable, in fact, in case of stochastic models and stochastic simulations. So now the question is, can we somehow compute values of this function faster, easier than by running traffic simulations? Such approaches to approximating given model are often called meta models, right? So now the question is, can we find a meta model approximating outcomes of simulations? So we may try to build some relatively easy models based on some relations between traffic speed, density, and flow on each road segment. But we can also try to do some data analysis and apply machine learning methods. So for example, if we have some partial values of this function that we would like to approximate, then maybe we can somehow find a good model indeed approximating relations between input and output in this data. So it may be linear regression, for example, but it turns out that in case of such complex system as traffic in a large city with traffic signals in different vertices of graph of the road network, this is much more complex problem. This function that we want to approximate is much more complicated. So maybe let's try neural networks, right? There are some theoretical foundations behind it, universal approximation theorem, which says that any continuous function may be approximated with arbitrary accuracy by a feed-forward neural network with only one single hidden layer. but the theorem doesn't say anything about required training time, required size of data set, so how many neurons we should have in this neural network. And today we know that neural networks with more layers are usually better than neural networks with only a single hidden layer. So this theorem doesn't give us a solution to the problem, but it just suggests that neural networks might be good universal approximators of many complex functions. So maybe our case, traffic simulation model, might be such good function, relatively easy to be approximated by neural networks. So let's try it, right? Let's try to approximate traffic simulation outcomes using neural networks. So first, to do it, to train neural networks, we need to have training set, right? So we can generate training set using our traffic simulation. So since 2009, I'm developing software for simulating traffic in a large scale, implementing microscopic model based on cellular automata. And I can use this tool to indeed run simulations. We can give a specific configuration of traffic signals, for example, as an input to traffic simulation. So in this case, the input is just a vector of 15 values, 15 traffic signal offsets. So offset of a traffic signal in a given crossroad is just a number of seconds from the beginning of simulation to the first switch of phase of this traffic signal from red phase to green light. And the simulation, after some time, may give us the output. For example, the total waiting time of cars on a given area in Warsaw. And when we have such data set generated by a large number of simulations, we can indeed try to train neural networks to approximate these outcomes of simulations. So indeed, in our experiments, we focused on approximating the total waiting time on a red signal as a function of this signal offsets. As I explained, signal offset was just a vector, 15-element vector representing traffic signal settings on a relatively small area in Warsaw. This was Stara Ochota district, close to my faculty of mathematics and computer science. So first, using this tool to simulate traffic, we're using traffic simulation framework. We generated a training set composed of more than 100,000 elements, and of course this set was later divided into training set, validation, and test set. Each simulation was aimed to approximate or simulate 10 minutes of real traffic with 42,000 of cars on a realistic map of Warsaw. So this road network structure was taken from Open Street Map Service, which is open source. The tool implements a microscopic simulation model based on cellular automata. So this is extension of a quite well-known in traffic engineering model, which is the Nagel-Schreckenberg model, but extended by me to simulate traffic on arbitrary road network. And so having this training set, together with my colleagues, we developed a tool based on TensorFlow and using TensorFlow library, which we called TensorTraffic, to indeed approximate outcomes of traffic simulations using neural networks and predict what may happen, what might be the total waiting time if we change traffic signal settings. So we tested many architectures of neural networks and values of hyperparameters of these neural networks. Each neural network was trained just on a training set, which was a subset of the whole set we generated. And we found out that indeed outcomes of traffic simulations can be approximated using neural networks with a good accuracy. So the best average error on a validation set was a bit more than 1%. So this is quite good approximation. The maximal error was less than 7%. And what is important is that if we train this neural network, then the time required to obtain results of simulations, so to approximate results of simulations, is much lower than the time of computing these values using traffic simulation. So simulating traffic on this road network of Warsaw, simulating 10 minutes of traffic lasts about a few minutes on this machine. In case of neural networks, after training, it is less than 1 second, about 0.2 second, even without a very good GPU. And what is also important is that in this case, we even don't need very large or very deep neural networks, right? We tested many different architectures with different layers, different number of neurons. So these are just configurations of neural networks for which we conducted most of our experiments. So these were just neural networks with from 3 to 7 hidden layers and from 50 to 400 neurons per layer. So these are not very large neural networks comparing to many other architectures that are used nowadays in machine learning and AI. But it turned out that even in such case, for such neural networks, it is possible to achieve quite good accuracy of these approximations. So I already explained inputs to these neural networks. So these are our representation. This is our representation of traffic signal settings in Stara Ochota. So outputs approximated to the total waiting time of all vehicles on a red signal. So time in which these vehicles had speed 0 kilometers per hour. And each neural network was a feed-forward, fully connected neural network with ReLU activation function. So this is just a special and quite typical kind of activation function neural networks. And we also tested different sizes of training sets, because from practical engineering point of view, it is important to have the smallest possible training set, which can give sufficient accuracy, because generating training set is also time consuming, right? We also tested different values of learning rate parameter and different values of dropout probability, so randomly removing some units to prevent overfitting. We introduced early stopping mechanism to finish training when the accuracy and values of loss function stopped improving. And so in total, we tested almost 300 different models, different architectures of neural networks. And we ran our experiments on, indeed, using TensorFlow framework with support of GPU on machines from Microsoft and Cloud Azure from Microsoft, on a special cluster from NVIDIA. And so as I said, results are quite good, because the best achieved average error was a bit more than 1%, with a maximal error less than 7% on a validation set consisting of more than 20,000 elements. So I also explained this improvement in terms of speed of computations. So this is a setting for which we achieved best results. So only three hidden layers with a learning rate 0.01 and also specific value of a dropout parameter. But if we see and try to compare these values for other architectures, it turned out that the size and structure of neural networks is important in this case. So for deeper architectures, we didn't achieve such good results. Probably the training set was too small, but this is my assumption. So in terms of other parameters, such as, for example, the size of a training set of values of learning curve or dropout, I will also present tables comparing best results. So this is also a table with best architectures and best configurations in terms of maximal error of this approximation. And this is typical distribution of relative error of approximation. So as you can see, similar to normal distribution. So for most cases, this error of approximation is relatively low indeed. And this is a comparison of results for different sizes of training sets. So there are not significant differences, but indeed, as I explained, it is important from engineering perspective to have the smaller possible training set. So it turns out that a training set composed of even a bit more than 10,000 elements may be sufficient for this case. This is comparison in terms of these different structures of neural networks. So also you can see that smaller architectures for usually gave a bit better results. And this is comparison in terms of values of parameter learning rate. So here, this values of learning rate in the middle turned out to be best. And it's similar for values of dropout. Yeah, so in each table, in each column, we have the average value of average error, which I mean this average error was also averaged on over all configurations of neural networks with a given value, for example, of dropout of or training set. And so this is the first value. The next is the median. Later is the best average error and the worst. So we see that we can indeed apply neural networks to approximate these outcomes of traffic simulations. So, and it looks that it may have many important engineering applications, for example, in real-time traffic management, right? Because we can collect real-time traffic data and try to find typical patterns of traffic, typical states of traffic, for which we can train offline our neural networks and, for example, find optimal settings of traffic signals or other parameters. But our neural networks will be just optimal for these typical traffic profiles, right? So, but now the question is, what if the traffic state is far from typical, right? So probably we should recalibrate our traffic simulation, maybe run some additional simulations, and also retrain our neural networks, right? And then trying to find better settings. So this is still an open problem, how to do it efficiently. But assuming that we can, even in a typical case, find good good configurations of neural networks or other machine learning algorithms approximating traffic simulations, then we can apply it to optimize traffic, right? Because we may try to search through a large space of possible traffic signal settings in order to find optimal options. For this, we can apply meta-heuristics such as genetic algorithm, in which we can just encode this traffic signal settings as genotypes and apply standard genetic algorithms. So we run experiments with genetic algorithm implemented using PyEvolve library, which is quite a popular library for running genetic algorithms in Python. It turns out that also in this case, we can achieve quite good results, right? So initially, in this algorithm, we randomly selected some relatively small subset of all possible values of traffic signal settings. So for example, 900 or even 50 different traffic signal settings. And after some number of iterations, the genetic algorithm was able to find traffic signal settings and just generate new traffic signal setting, which were better by at least a few percent than best traffic signal settings in this initial randomly selected population. And just to have comparison why this algorithm is quite good and efficient, we also ran experiment in which we randomly selected 10 million of different traffic signal settings. So evaluated all of these settings using GPU. It took about a bit more than 600 seconds. So the best traffic signal setting was this total waiting time more than 35,000 seconds of waiting of all cars, but it looks that if we run only a few thousand of such evaluations, it is possible to find settings which are even better in terms of this total waiting time. So in five of these six cases, this or four of these six cases, the total waiting time was better than randomly selected case. In case of this randomly selection, right, for the best case from a large random set. So it may be results might be applied not only to traffic optimization, but also for traffic planning or for transport planning, because similarly we can try to find optimal locations and capacities of parkings or charging stations for electric vehicles or stations for car sharing, and we, using simulation, we can evaluate how good in terms of some fitness function, how good are our configurations. And similarly, if we want to indeed evaluate very large number of possible configurations, then this meta models based on machine learning might be indeed a good solution. So it may be especially beneficial in a large scale, in cases when we need to run large number of simulations. And in the era of connected and autonomous vehicles, which is expected to come very soon, because in this case, we might be able also to predict and to model with much better accuracy traffic of such cars, right? Because one error which we have is error caused by approximation of simulation using machine learning. But there is also another error caused by just building model, microscopic traffic model, simulation model, which is also some kind of approximation of a real traffic. So in case of vehicles which will be just steered by a computer and not a human driver, then these predictions and this method might be especially useful. So in this research, we used resources, computational resources provided to us by NVIDIA and Microsoft Research. So that's why we are able to run simulations on very good GPU. And I also had access to traffic data, floating car data, collecting from mobile devices by CE Traffic Company. We are collaborating right now in Horizon 2020 project Melodic. So right now I'm collaborating with more than 10 scientists from different countries. And if you are interested in collaboration, I also invite you to join. These are just points for possible future work on this project. So of course we can try to analyze and optimize some other traffic control strategies, not only settings, but maybe some adaptive policies of traffic signal control. There might be other inputs to neural networks, for example, road network structure, right, or travel demand. We may try to optimize this traffic not only using meta-heuristic genetic algorithms, but also using deep reinforcement learning, similarly as in case of AlphaGo, for example. So we may try to find this optimal architecture of neural networks using methods like AutoML, so some kind of automatic methods, and not using grid search, which we used in our research. So yeah, there might be also some other machine learning algorithms. For example, XGBoost also gave us quite good results. So these are just plans for future work in case of traffic, but it's easy to see that the similar approaches might be also used to approximate outcomes of other simulations. So maybe these methods might be used not only in case of traffic. We also run experiments on another tool for simulating traffic, but in a single straight lane, but this time in a stochastic model. So also extension of this Nagel-Schreckenberg model. And it turned out that also, in this case, neural networks are able to quite accurately approximate distribution, this time distribution of cars in the output. So maybe this ability to be easily approximated by neural networks is a general ability cellular automata, right, which were used to model this traffic. So maybe we can similarly try to approximate and predict outcomes of simulation of other cellular automata, such as Game of Life, for example, which was proven to be Turing complete. So perhaps it might be possible to build a universal tool to find approximate solutions of maybe some class of computational problems, right? This may also have very interesting theoretical results. And similarly, cellular automata are used nowadays to model many other complex processes, and not only traffic, but also in medicine, for example, cancer growth. So similarly, as we try to predict how different traffic signal settings impact traffic, we can also perhaps try to predict how, for example, different strategies of therapy, for example, days of radiotherapy, impact growth of tumor, of cancer. And there are also scientists with whom I collaborate on this topic. So yeah, as a conclusion, the most important conclusion is that indeed, in case of these traffic models based on cellular automata and these traffic signal settings, neural networks are good approximators, are good tools to approximate outcomes of simulations, which potentially may have many interesting practical and engineering applications. And if you are interested to work on this topic, I invite you to join the team. Thank you for your attention.
Unluckily, we don't have time for questions, but thank you for your attention, and I welcome you for another track.